नमस्कार फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट दिस सब्जेक्ट बेसिक इलेक्ट्रिकल इंजीनियरिंग यूनिट नंबर 5 इलेक्ट्रिकल इंस्टॉलेशंस। द मेजर टॉपिक इज अर्थिंग सिस्टम्स। इंट्रोडक्शन। द टर्म अर्थिंग इज द कनेक्शन ऑफ जनरल मास ऑफ अर्थ टू इलेक्ट्रिकल एपरेटस इन सच अ मैनर एज टू एंश्योर ऑल टाइम एंड इमीजिएट एनर्जी डिस्चार्ज विदाउट डेंजर। The earth is made up of a material that is electrically conductive. A fault current will flow to the earth through the live conductor, provided it is earthed. The conventional system of earthing is done by digging of a large pit into which a GI pipe or a copper plate is positioned with the layers of charcoal and salt. When system is without earthing, and if short circuit occurs and human body touches the metal part, the current will not get path through human body because circuit is already provided with low resistance path through the earthing. An effective earthing is made through any wire, pipe, rod or metal plate known as earth electrode. The connecting wire between electrical apparatus and earth electrode is known as earthing lead or main earthing conductor. Purpose of earthing: to avoid electric shock to human body, to avoid risk of fire due to earth leakage current through unwanted path, ensure that all exposed conductive parts do not reach a dangerous potential, maintain the voltage at any part of an electrical system. The qualities of a good earthing: must be low electrical resistance, must be of good corrosion resistance, must be able to dissipate high fault current repeatedly. Then types of earthing. There are major two types of earthing. One is pipe earthing and the next is plate earthing. Now let us start with pipe earthing in detail. Pipe earthing is the most commonly adopted method and is a best system of earthing compared to the other systems. You can also visualize this pipe earthing besides figure. In this method, pipe of sufficient diameter is selected whose size is depend upon the maximum earth current of that installation and type of soil. As per Indian standard 732-1963, the GI pipe shall not be less than 30 mm diameter and 2 meter long for ordinary soil. If cast iron is used, then internal diameter should be of 10 mm. The depth at which pipe should be buried depends upon condition of soil and moisture. For pipe earthing, a pit of 40 square mm is dug in the soil and pipe having tapered at the bottom is placed vertical in the pit. The charcoal and salt are filled in that pit alternately in layers about 2 meters from bottom and for a distance of about 15 centimeter around the pipe. This is done to increase the dampness and moisture of soil surrounding the pipe. The pipe placed has 12 mm diameter hole, drilling in it so that water poured from top is easily spread in the media surrounding the pipe, which helps in maintaining the resistance of earth. At a top, cement concrete work is done to provide protection against mechanical damage. A water pouring arrangement is provided by a funnel with wire mesh at the top. Next is plate earthing. You can refer this figure. In plate earthing, the earth electrodes, that means plate, made up of galvanized iron, GI, or steel or copper. For copper plate, thickness is not less than 3.15 mm and for GI or steel plate, it is not less than 6.30 mm. The size of plate should be 60 by 60 centimeter. The plate should be buried such that top edge is a depth of not less than 1.5 meter below the surface of the ground. The peat of a 4 meter dug into the ground and the earthing plate is placed vertical in that pit. The space around the plate is filled with layers of charcoal and salt for a minimum thickness of 15 cm. For connection of earth wire to the plate, a GI pipe of 12.7 mm diameter is connected to the earthing plate. The earth wire properly secured to plate with the help of nut, bolt and washer. The peat filled with charcoal and salt is also connected with a pipe for carrying water from concrete work of that area. This will help in increasing the dampness and moisture surrounding the plate. No earth electrode should have a resistance more than 3 ohm measured by an earth resistance meter. In rocky soil, the resistance may be up to 8 ohm. The copper plate earthing needs to be changed every 12 years due to corrosion attacks. Neutral earthing. Neutral earthing is the process of connecting a star point of a transformer, generator, and motor to the ground. It protects the system against arcing ground. It keeps balanced voltage with respect to earth. It provides greater safety to the lightning. Its maintenance and operating cost is low. It is reliable in operation. Types of neutral earthing. All AC power system is operated with neutral grounded. It is classified as per voltage level as below. First is solid earthing. In this, neutral point is connected to the earth without intentional resistance or reactance. It is used below 660 volt. Next is resistance earthing. In this method, neutral point is connected to the earth through resistance. It is used between 3.3 kV to 11 kV. Reactance earthing. In this method, neutral point is connected to the earth through reactance. It is as good as compared to resistance earthing for same voltage level. Resonant earthing. The value of reactance is selected so as to neutralize the power frequency capacitive current between line and earth. It is used for medium voltage transmission line which is connected to generator with intervening power transformer. If you have any query, you can email us on bhavin.kanani@darshan.ac.in. For more detail, you can visit our website www.darshan.ac.in. Thank you.